Good day. The state television company of Western Armenia presents all the most important events of these days. Today's broadcast. The final session of the National Assembly of Western Armenia was held. Schools and kindergartens of Hadrut and Shushi will have new buildings in Stepanakert. Azerbaijan submitted an illegal intelligence report on the Armenian community of Argentina. Why Iran decided to open a General Consulate in Kapan. Kilis, an ancient city in Western Armenia. The end of the Innocence Guillermo Karamanian. The Bureau of the U.S. State Department for Europe and Eurasia calls on Baku to quickly release all captives. Archeological relics from Shushi, new exhibition in Erebuni Museum. The final session of the National Assembly of Western Armenia was attended by deputies from different countries and President of Western Armenia Armenak Abrahamian. President Armenak Abrahamian made a speech at the beginning of the meeting, who concluded his speech with New Year's wishes addressing to Western Armenia and the Armenian people. During the meeting, the proposals of the commissions were discussed, as well as issues related to parliamentarians removed from the National Assembly in 2021. NA President Leonardo Basmajan concluded the session by congratulating the deputies on the new year of the Armenians of Western Armenia. According to the message distributed by the Office of the President of Artsakh, Araik Harutyunyan received the working collectives of a number of secondary and music schools in Hadrut and Shushi. In the person of those present, he expressed gratitude to the employees of the creative institutions of the communities of the occupied territories of Artsakh, who in this difficult period and under the prevailing difficult conditions faithfully performed, are doing their work, providing an interrupted educational process for displaced students. Araik Harutyunyan also noted that from September 1, 2022, schools and kindergartens in Hadrut and Shushi will have new separate buildings in the capital, Stepanakert. Answering the teachers' question about the future and security, the president stressed that the people and authorities of Artsakh will never accept any status as part of Azerbaijan, and the country's safe life is provided and will be provided by the Defense Army and a peacekeeping contingent of the Russian Federation. Azerbaijan compiled and published an illegal intelligence report on the Armenian community in Argentina on December 23. The report analyzes Armenian institutions and provides personal data on the various figures of the Argentine community. He also condemns those people in the field of politics who contributed to the struggle for recognition of the genocide of Armenian people, as well as those who expressed their opinion during the Artsakh War unleashed by Azerbaijan and Turkey in 2020. The text systematically denies the genocide of Armenian people, repeating the official position of the denial of the governments of Azerbaijan and Turkey. The report accuses the Armenian community of Argentina for ignorance about the current political situation in Armenia, as well as hindering dialogue with Turkey and Azerbaijan. According to Diario Armenia, this is an illegal report in Argentina whose national intelligence law prohibits foreign organizations from preparing or performing tasks in the country. According to Iranian scholar Jana Vartanyan, the opening of the General Consulate in Kapan indicates that Iran does not want to remain outside the processes in the South Caucasus and wants to ensure its direct presence in the region. Another circumstance of the opening of the General Consulate of Iran in Kapan is due to the situation that has developed after the 44-day war in Artsakh. There was very serious criticism of the authorities of Iran that they are ongoing in the South Caucasus, the Iranian expert noted. According to Vartanyan, the opening of the consulate is also to some extent connected with the claims of Azerbaijan, which wants to have a corridor in the Sunni region towards Nakhichevan, which may to some extent undermine the security of the Armenian-Iranian border. Therefore, it is no coincidence that the Iranian side often voices the need to implement joint programs between this country and Sunni. The ancient city of Kilis in Western Armenia is located 55 km from Ain Tab and 10 km from the border of Syria. Kilis was one of the most important cities of Kitite state and hosted many other civilizations. This is a city that has been constantly inhabited by mankind since the days of settled life and culture. It was the cradle of such civilization as Babylon, Hittite state, Hurrian Mitan, Aramic, Assyrian, Roman, Byzantine, Mamluk and Ottoman empires. Kilis consists of stone houses that opened to narrow streets and numerous ancient religious buildings such as mosque churches. The dishes are based on meat and bulgur, but vegetable dishes are also prepared according to the season. There are also castles left over from ancient times. We all know who the three kings really are, according to Bible. Many of us would like to remain innocent and be in the imagination that children are, but time rashly reveals the truth. Indeed, 600 years of Turkish domination seems too long not to realize the full extent of our enemy, especially when this evil period of barbaric domination reached its peak, committing genocide against our ancestors. Read the full article on our official website. The Bureau of European and Eurasian Affairs of the US State Department calls for the rapid release of all captives in Azerbaijan. We call for a quick release of the other captives, exchange their remains, and keep records of the missing. We emphasize the human attitude towards captives in accordance with international obligations, the US State Department's Bureau for Europe and Eurasia noted. A temporary exhibition, Archeological Relics from Shushi, has opened in Historical and Archeological Museum Reserve Erebuni. Unique archaeological objects of Shushi Carpet Museum were presented, mainly ceramics and metal products, jugs, ornaments, daggers and coins. All of them were located on the territory of Artsakh and date back to the 2nd and 6th centuries. During the 44-day war in 2020, it was possible to excavate carpets and other archaeological items for important exhibits of museum. According to the archaeologists, most of the exhibits belong to the Aetium culture of Armenian highlands. The phenomenon is that a late Bronze Iron period, in the face of the Aetium culture, it can be stated that almost the entire territory of Armenian highlands was culturally homogeneous, said Mikhail Badalyan, director of the Historical and Archaeological Museum Reserve Erebuni. The exhibition will last until May 29. Now the musical part, Armenian folk song. The full version of this video is available on Western Armenia's YouTube channel. This was all for today. Goodbye.